Okay, it's about that time of the year. Here it is, late November. We're going to be looking forward now to the upcoming winter weather season. And in making up this winter weather forecast, we looked at a ton of different weather indicators. But there were major ones that we really placed a lot of emphasis on. Let's take a look at a few of those. These include the El Niño-La Niña zone. They also include the sea surface temperatures in the Pacific Ocean as well as the Atlantic Ocean, because it's a known fact when we have certain setups of these warm and cold waters, the jet streams can change big time for an extended period of time. We also looked at what we call the Arctic Oscillation and North Atlantic Oscillation. What's important to know here is that when the two oscillations are in a certain mode, we call that the negative mode or negative phase, the jet stream can change and buckle big time, allowing for cold air to spill south. And it's usually during these times that we pick up our best chances for significant wintry weather, and we think we'll have those chances, especially later on during the winter season. Now, because the winter season looks so variable right now, we've broken it down for you month by month. Let's go over to the Weather Center. Meteorologist Jared Heil is here in the Weather Center with me right now, taking a look at the month of December, which, by the way, looks pretty good right now.
Not too far away. We feel pretty good about this forecast, and if you like the warm stuff like I do, you really like this forecast because it looks very warm across much of the country. Low pressure in the upper levels of the atmosphere sitting well toward the west and off toward the east. That means high pressure in the middle, right on top of this part of the country. So what's that mean for us? Above normal temperatures, the cooler air relative to normal southeast and also well toward the west over portions of Canada. Very wet on the west coast if you're traveling toward that part of the country. But in terms of precipitation, because the jet's so far north, it's going to take the rain with it, Jay. It looks fairly dry for the month of December. Could be changing, though, and becoming more wintry by January and February.
Yeah, snow lover then, December, not your month.
So we'll have to just keep on trying here.
That could change, though, as Jared mentioned, as we move into January and February. Let's take a look at what we're expecting for January. Notice the jet stream. Notice how it's dipping a little farther south into the United States. What that's going to allow is the colder air that's been building up in Canada to also move farther south. Now, even though we're expecting near normal temperatures in the Louisville area and our vicinity, there's still going to be chances for occasional cold air outbreaks. Right now with the precip, the better chances for those big snows look to be along the mid-Atlantic into the northeast and also well out west. That's not to say we won't have anything around here. Still expecting near normal precipitation, but nonetheless, the bigger snows look to be east and west.
And with that little dip, maybe a little bit of wintry weather.
Oh, absolutely. Could be some ice in there.
Yeah. And then if we don't get anything in January, there's still February, which
looks cold.
Fairly wintry. Jay talked about the Arctic Oscillation and when that could become negative. We see our cold weather. We think February is the month where that could happen. You can see the dip in the jet stream right through the Ohio Valley with high pressure well toward the west. That sends the warmth well west. We see the opposite, below average temperatures. And because if it's cooler than normal, our precip comes more in the form of snow, and it takes more snow to produce liquid than it does, of course, just plain old rain. We're expecting at or below average precipitation for the month of February. So what's it all mean for the winter as a whole? Well, here's Jay for more on that and, of course, how much snow we're expecting.
All right, Jared, thanks so very much. So the bottom line, let's go ahead and summarize everything, and we've gone month by month by month. This is what you can expect now as we dive on into the upcoming winter season. As far as temperatures are concerned, it appears that December, no doubt, will be our warmest month of the winter season. February looks to be the coldest. January, kind of in between near normal. As far as precipitation, the driest looks to be December. Normal amounts of precip for January and February, when you factor everything together, just about near normal precipitation for the three-month period. And snowfall right now looks to be at maybe a little bit below normal. So how much snow are we expecting? Generally speaking, with the data we have right now, anywhere from 9 to 12 inches for the entire winter season here in the Louisville area. Our typical yearly snowfall is just about 12 inches as well. Again, it's still early in the game. Bottom line, as more and more information comes in, we'll be updating our forecasts right here at WLKY and, of course, WLKY.com. One thing's for sure, it's going to be fun to see how things turn out during the upcoming winter season 2012-2013.